Well, hello, and my name is Clyde Hall, and I'm one of the founders of the Dance for All People that has been danced for some 30 plus years around the country. The dance has always said, be prepared for great change, sometimes small change, but great change in the world. After the Northwest Dance of 2019, we all began to realize the scope of what was going to happen, and indeed, our life and our precious dance was going to change. And in fact, it couldn't go on any further until this time has passed, of which we're at the time of this recording, still in the throes of it. In my opinion, COVID is not going to go away. If you recall, the Spanish flu of 1918 didn't ever go away. That's the reason why we still have flu shots today. So indeed, it has changed the face of everything. And we had to do a quick regrouping. Well, what are we going to do? And there's always been a practice of dancing from afar for people that want to attend that could tune in, be on the same wavelength, be on the same, with the same prayers and the same feelings and emotions. And so that's what we did. We amped up that dancing from afar mode. So that changed all our lives. Personally, in their family units, statewide, nationwide, worldwide. So you had a chance to look inward, have an inward perspective, not only on yourself, but on your family and your greater Naraya family, establishing new and different connections. And at first, that was rather hard for people because, as my friend Laney Tom says, you know, we look forward to what he says, quote, family reunions. Some of the friendships, kinships are decades long. And of course, meeting new people too, as well. That's all an element that's been woven together in a very tight and wonderful weave in a very wonderful tapestry. And, all of a sudden, that personal connection was not there. And you had to do your observances from your home or wherever you could to maintain a connection to these people. And of course, that's when Joan Henry and I instituted our fireside chats that went on most of last year, which people found tremendously helpful. And talking about the various dances that was coming up and the different methods that people were using for tying into the dance. And so those worked out well. It was a connection, you know, a weaving of another length of this tapestry in a different way, a different design. And now, happy to say, there is dances that has occurred in limited numbers, severely limited numbers. And we're starting to revive the personal dances, but admittedly on a smaller scale. But still, it's good to have them happening again and good to have that personal type of a connection once again. As far as me and my reaction to the COVID here, although I've raised my grandson, Joe Angelo, since he was a small child, 3 years old, I suddenly found myself also having to take care of his sister, who was 12, and his younger brother, who's 9. And so they're still with me today, and I don't know how long they're going to be, but that was a new challenge to occupy my time, having three children, ages 9, 12, and 14 is a challenge at my ripe old age of 70 years and my sister's of 65. And we've been persevering with that. But one of the wonderful things that opened up was during these times of the dances, we hold a regular pipe ceremony. I and a friend, Scott Pauling, and whoever else wants to attend, including the kids. And that gave me the opportunity to do a lot of things with my grandkids that I wouldn't ordinarily have had the opportunity to do, such as teaching them songs and also pipe ritual. Both Joangelo and Alicia now carry their own little pipes, and they know all the do's and don'ts of the ritual, and they know what they're supposed to do to live their lives when they carry these pipes. And so they very much look forward to having these. And that's become their, quote, church. That's when they exercise their spirituality, is during those ceremonies. And we look forward to having that every time we have a dance and I'm home and not traveling like I've been recently. With the dances, we'll hold the pipe ceremony and a feast with it. And it's all very sweet. And so it's given me time with the kids that I wouldn't ordinarily have had. So that was a great gift that COVID gave to me, is spending time with my little folks to do this. The idea of being isolated, everybody being in the type of quarantine, it gives you the aspect of being able to contemplate yourself and where your life's going, how you're doing, for better or worse. And so that's been something that has been beneficial for me, is introspection and looking inward on the things that you value and the things that you love and the people that you love and care about, and of course yourself. How are you doing? Are you taking good care of yourself? Or what's your relationship to yourself and your family and your friends and the world is, amongst other things? So that's been a good one for me, is doing that. And always trying to keep up the faith, say your prayers on a regular basis, cedar your house down, and make sure that things are going as smoothly as possible, even in times of adversity, to try to make the best of it, with always with spirit there being involved on an everyday basis, every minute, every hour, to guide you along, should you choose. And with me, there's been a whole bunch of people here on the reservation that have died from COVID, and personal friends, relatives, many elders. And that's kind of put a new perspective on things too, is that having that happen, because as you know, your life goes on and on, la la la, but you didn't expect a whole bunch of people that you knew to be suddenly taken from you, and you would never see them again on this earth. And so that's been something that one has had to cope with too. It's a lot of that. But what about the future? How are things going to look for each one of us, with our families, with our circle of friends, with the community that we live in, with the large extended Naraya family and community that exists and has existed for some 30 odd years? So the spirit has been protecting us so far. And that's the thing that we have to continue to pray, to support each other like a net, a finely woven net to catch our brother or sister when they fall and to help them along. Pray for them. When people come into your mind, stop right then and there and pray for them, because there's some reason they are needing that prayer right now. And our communities will start again. There's no doubt about that. Right now, the dances that have been held in person are like little seedlings growing up, pushing up from the soil, pushing up, and their little green heads coming up again. You know, it's a rebirth of the dance, and even the way that we do the dance, because before we always pretty much knew what was going to happen during the ceremony. But at this point, things look forward to some change, some subtle change and some radical change in the way we do things with these dances when we do get together again on a personal basis. And I should pray that to everybody in the Naraya community, hold the faith and say your prayers. Take care of yourself. Take care of the people that are around you, your circle of family, your circle of friends, the circle of those that you love and care about. And we will all get through this and come out on the other side, and like that little plant, prosper in the sun. So thank you.